Hi, I'm Peter. Welcome to Back to Basics. I don't know about you, but I'm the type of person that needs 3 alarms to wake up. I'll set up my system so that I have my first alarm, and then I'll have my second and third alarm about 5 minutes later. I do this so that I don't have to rely on myself to hit that snooze button or set up an alarm while I'm trying to wake up. What does this have to do with AWS? Well, at AWS, we would call this system a statically stable system. Static stability means your system doesn't have to react to or do anything different to make up for any lost functionality. The things involved to make changes to a system are control plane actions, like creating a new EC2 instance if one fails. In my case, that's creating a new alarm in my half-asleep state, which runs the risk of me falling asleep with the phone in my hand. Instead, the data plane are the things that keep running, like a running EC2 instance, or my second and third alarm that are already set up and ready to go. Control plane actions can have so many moving parts, which lowers their chance of success, especially during a failure. So how do we make our systems more resilient? We can rely on the data plane to isolate problem areas. You can create this isolation with availability zones. You can design your system to isolate traffic within an AZ using a circuit breaker pattern. You can close a circuit to prevent requests from entering AZs with the failure. This helps isolate the failure within an AZ and prevent resources and healthy ones from interacting with the failed ones. Let's see how this plays out in a load balance application. To do this, you'll want to turn off cross-zone load balancing. Although it's a common pattern to use cross-zone load balancing, the downside here is that it prevents AZ isolation. It's hard to pinpoint where a host is failing because traffic goes to all AZs. We can't turn on the circuit breaker without bringing the whole system down if we don't know where the problem is. So instead, we'll turn cross-zone load balancing off to isolate failures within an AZ. We can use this pattern to avoid the AZ with the failure entirely using data plane actions, just like how I avoid having to hit the snooze button or create a new alarm. How do you find failures? Health checks from services like Elastic Load Balancers or Amazon Route 53 can help detect hard failures like unresponsive hosts. But not all failures are hard failures. Being able to detect gray failures like software bugs, packet loss, or out of control latency depend on how well you instrument metrics. You can write a small piece of code with Amazon CloudWatch Synthetics to constantly make calls against your endpoint. In our case, you'll be able to see the zonal DNS name of our load balancer. You can then run canary tests against each AZ and compare them actively to see which AZs are abnormal. Then, we can remove the problem AZ entirely from the system using the data plane. This turns a gray failure into a hard failure. You can use zonal shift with Route 53 Application Recovery Controller to isolate and avoid the AZ with the failure. When you start a zonal shift, traffic will start to drain away from the AZ you want to avoid, and then stop entirely. You don't have to spend time looking at logs, trying to figure out what the problem is. You simply just shift it away using the data plane. Eventually, you figure out what the issue is and cancel the zone shift call. Things go back to normal again. You assumed any gray failure to be a hard failure, isolated the issue, and used data plane actions to recover from the failure. This is an example of a statically stable system. If you go this route, DNS will essentially dictate how much load shows up in each AZ. You may experience some unevenness, so it's important to make sure you have equal capacity in all AZs. Designing a system based on the minimum healthy target count for your workload is a good way to measure that. Also, plan so that you have enough capacity to sustain loss of one AZ. If we deliberately take one out, assuming a hard failure, then we want to plan accordingly and tolerate the loss of an AZ. There are lots of other examples in the Amazon Builders Library to help you build more resilient systems. Check out the links below to learn more. Thanks for watching Back to Basics, and see you next time.